Don't bite, no guys.
How you guys doing today?
I'm good.
Good. Everybody excited?
Yeah.
Sure. Ready to roll?
Woo!
All right. Cool. Awesome. If you guys don't be afraid to get close. I don't think anybody's been flying around, so you should be able to hear me yell at you. But if you can't hear what I'm saying, definitely squeeze it in. We'll just kind of do a quick crew brief here for these guys. I'll brief them up, then I'll talk to you guys, give you some safety stuff, passenger brief, and then translate the crew brief or answer questions you have or whatever you guys want to do. We'll have plenty of time, and then we'll get started. Sound good?
Yes, sir.
All right, cool. All right, so to kick it off, crew attention to brief. Time now, we got 2-8. We'll man a 4-5 for 0-0 takeoff. The weather today, we got a broken layer right about 1700s, they're saying. It looks like it's a little bit better than that. Shouldn't be a factor with the clouds for us today. The winds are out of the north, pretty light. So we will watch those throughout our show. For the show site today, the show line is going to be the inboard edge of the runway. The 500-foot line is the Foxtrot taxiway. Certain points marked by white trailer. If we have an emergency today, call and knock it off. We'll climb and cope. Just as situation type of demonstration or not. If we do have an emergency, we'll handle it towards the NATOS. We'll come back here and land runway 32, plan 4, unless something else makes sense. For the demonstration, I'm going to take the approach on runway 32 right here. We'll set max power, release the brakes at 80 knots to take the yoke at BMC execute load transition to 150, 170, 45 degrees nose up, the 110 push over the top. We'll accelerate level at 135. We'll clean up 150, clear left and right. 170, call maneuvering speed. I'll call rolling to be a 60-degree angle bank turn to the left for an offset heading of 238, followed by a 60-degree angle bank turn to the right. We'll be in for the parade pass. We'll descend no greater than 4,000 feet per minute, no lower than 500 feet till contact. We'll target out to 300 feet. Passing the crowd line, I'll call rolling to be 6 degree angle bank turn to the left for an offset heading of, for our egress line. Once I'm established on the egress heading, I'll level the wings, call pulling to be 10 degrees nose up to target out to 1,000 feet. Once we're set there at 2 miles, I'll call rolling to be 6 degree angle bank turn to the left. We'll be in for the flat pass. I'll just say 4,000 feet per minute, lower than 500 feet till contact with no lower than 200 feet to the wings are level, target out to the 50 feet. We'll push up 320 knots. Past the center point, call standby, standby center point, I'll call pulling. It'll be 10 degrees nose up again, followed by a 6-degree angle bank turn to the left for the min radius turn. We won't go below 500 feet till I'm contact. We'll target 200 feet for that running for the head-on. At 0.5 miles, I'll call pulling. It'll be 20 degrees nose up this time with 60-degree angle bank turn to the left for our downwind. We'll configure on speed. At 2 miles, I'll call rolling. It'll be 45-degree angle bank turn to the left for our push to land. Once we're on parameters, I'll call for flaps to 100, set power flat idle or the throttles. At 95 knots, I'll call pushing. It'll be 25 degrees nose down into a max effort stop. Once we're on the deck, we will go full reverse on the props, full max brakes. We'll stop at center point. We'll back up, face crowd, flash lights, talk to Mo, and exit back here parking. Any questions? Right, freeze.
Oh, there it is. Yeah. There it is.
Yeah. Little parting handshake.
We did a parting.
That's right. How's it play, guys?
Sure.
Awesome.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Something,
I would like a quiz of one of those guys. But.
Something I forgot to do is introduce the crew to you guys. You could probably tell for the Marines in the crowd, some of the service members who makes up our crew. We have our flight engineer is Staff Sergeant Kevin Sanchez. Our navigator is Staff Sergeant Adam Miller. We have a flight mech in the back who's going to be taking care of you guys and conducting business back there, Sergeant Zach Williford. We also have two petty officers with us today, Matt Noto and Phil Huntington are going to be with us. So those are the guys that are taking care of you. They're professionals. They do this all the time, every weekend, all over the place for a long time. So please listen to them when they give you guys instructions. They're not lying when they say sit down and strap in. Sit down and strap in. Things happen very quickly, so just pay attention to what they're telling you to do. They'll take care of you. For some safety stuff real quick, the boring things, we'll get it out of the way and then we'll start having fun. Primary entry and exit all day is going to be all the way in the front where you see the light coming through. That's our crew entrance door. You guys have probably gotten on and off that already as you've entered Fat Albert. That's where you're going to go. If we're going to do something different, these guys will tell you where to go and what to do. Please listen to them. Even if something makes sense to you in the back of the aircraft, they've got the headsets and they know what's going on outside the airplane, so just listen to what they're telling you to do. Even if it doesn't make sense, they'll get you where you need to go. Some other safety rules of the road. Like I said, when you get assigned your seat, sit down, strap that seatbelt in nice and tight. It's not like Southwest. In the Southwest, I like to clip the seatbelt and then pull it out as far as it'll go and then get my Snuggie on you. Don't do that. You'll float out of that seatbelt and you're going to end up right back here in a crumpled mess. So sit down, pull that thing nice and tight. If you think you got it tight, give it a couple more good tugs for me and make sure you stay in that seat and have a good time all day. Everything you guys take on the aircraft, you're going to have to take off the aircraft with you. So that includes cameras and notebooks and iPads and iPhones and all that kind of good stuff. Definitely, if you guys think you're going to lose that, stick it in a pocket. If you got a button-down pocket, that's best. But if not, just hang on to it. Feel free to take video, camera, or pictures, whatever you guys want to do during the flight. That's all good to go. Just make sure you hang on to that stuff. If you happen to let go of it and you see it floating around somewhere, just somebody grab it that can reach it. We'll sort out who it belongs to afterwards. Like I said, if you don't grab it, you're going to find it right back here in about 1,000 pieces. And that takes a long time to collect all those pieces. So definitely hang on to that stuff. The take it on, take it off rule also applies to the breakfast and lunch that you guys ate today. So that's going to come on with you. It's going to go off with you as well. If it's still in your body, also, if it's in a little plastic bag, that's cool too. No judgment for me. But everybody's going to get an air sick bag. Best way not to get sick is to be prepared to get sick on the plane. So take that as a souvenir from us. If you don't use it, you can, I don't know, write your name on it or send it to your grandmother. Whatever you want to do with it is yours. If you do use it, no need to prove it to me. I believe you say threw up. Just take that with you off the aircraft, and we'll find a treasure case for you to put that in somewhere and have as a memory. Let's see, what else am I missing? I think that applies. I think it's about everything. Anybody ridden on Fat Albert before? Anybody ridden on a C-130 before? Yeah, a couple guys. Yeah, a lot of people. All right, cool. This is going to be similar to C-130 ride. It's going to be a little bit different. So I'll talk through real quick for some of us that are a little bit unfamiliar. What we do here, the big takeaway from all of the stuff we're doing here today is to help show you guys a little bit about what we do in the Marine Corps. This is a Lockheed Martin C-130 aircraft. We use it in the Marine Corps for primarily aerial refueling. We have a lot of other missions that we use it for as well. Whatever we can do with it, we will do with it. We treat it as a tactical airframe. So what that means is it's not just logistical transport. We don't just take off from an airport, land at an airport, and move stuff around. We do a lot of other stuff. Sometimes we take off with things that we throw out the back in flight. Sometimes pop flares out the back, so we do all kinds of weird stuff with the plane. So what we're going to do for you guys is show you a little bit of what that looks like. So we're going to simulate for you today a combat takeoff and a combat landing. Those are some of the more dynamic portions of the flight because we actually touch the ground. The rest of the time we'll be close to the ground but not touching it. So what we'll do is we're gonna set max power, like you heard me tell the crew down here at this end, and I'm gonna release the brakes. So when I put all the power on the aircraft, you see these engines up here, they're pretty big, and they got big solid chewers, those big props out there in the front. Those things are gonna start spinning, they're gonna be biting the air, they're gonna wanna go. So you're gonna feel the airplane straining to move, but I'll be holding the brakes with these giant tires. That'll keep us in one spot. What that lets us do is get final checks on the engines and make sure everything's set and ready to go before we release the brakes. Once we release the brakes, it's go time. Like, we're getting up there one way or another, no matter what happens. So when we release the brakes, we'll start running on the runway. What I'm looking for is a very minimum safe speed. Once we hit that minimum safe speed to actually get the aircraft off the ground, and physicists and big brains have figured out what that speed is when I can control it and still fly it, I trust them. So we'll just hit that speed. I'll pick the aircraft up off the ground. It'll be about 120,000 pounds. We'll pick it up. We'll go about 3 to 5 feet down the runway as we accelerate to a tactical flying speed. So I'm about 6.5 feet tall. So is this guy right here. So we'll be around shoulder length, the bottom of the airplane, going down the runway as we cruise. So we'll hold that altitude, pick up speed really quickly. And then once we hit that tactical flying speed, I'm going to pull 2 G's on the airplane. We'll go 45 degrees nose up, and we'll climb out. The airspeed will start to ripple off. We call that trading airspeed for altitude. What that does for us is, well, we get going off the ground. We get the aircraft off the ground, so we're not picking up trees and shrubs and bushes and things like that in our gear, because we use this airplane in a lot of unimproved areas. So then we get that friction away from us. We accelerate quicker. It also keeps us low, so people might hear us, but they won't be able to see us or shoot at us. Once we get that speed, we'll trade that speed for the altitude. We accelerate through their weapons engagement zone very quickly. So by the time they do see us and can shoot at us, they can't get an effective solution before we're out of their range. That's the goal of what we're trying to do. So we'll do that. As I said, that airspeed is going to ripple off as we gain altitude. Well, we all know we get slow, right? Below the big brain number of airspeed, you're going to fall out of the sky and smash. That's no good. So before that happens, I'm going to push the nose over aggressively. What that'll do is it'll level off the airplane. It'll allow us to accelerate again. As we gain back that tactical flying speed. So those moments, you're going to feel 0 G's, maybe negative G's on the airplane. 0 G's, what you see the astronauts in space doing, they call it microgravity. I don't know what that means. It means when the stuff floats around. That's what it means to me. So when you hear this, when you see those 0 G's, you might see the stuff floating around. You'll see some of the guys, their feet will actually come up off the ground or off the deck of the aircraft. And then some negative G's is when things start to accelerate away from the Earth. That's why everything ends up right back here in a puddle. Because that's where it'll go once those negative G's come on. You guys will see, we'll go 0 G's, maybe even like negative 0.2, maybe negative 0.4 if we're really aggressive.
So it doesn't take much to get that effect. So you guys will see a little bit of that, level off. So then we'll accelerate from there. We'll clean up the airplane, and then we'll get into what we use as tactics in a combat environment to escape visual acquisition, escape radar acquisition, and hide, radar masking, things like that. So we'll demonstrate a little bit of that for you. What it boils down to is we get in terrain, we get behind terrain, we stay low to the ground, we get in the clutter so they can't see us or shoot at us. So we'll go left, we'll go right, you'll feel some G's pull on the airplane, you'll feel it unload at times as we're working our way around the area. Once we get set to land, you're going to feel us come in, we're going to do a real sharp climb again, then we're going to level off and you're going to feel a real strong left turn and a pull as we get ready to land. What I'm doing is I'm getting the airplane, again, out of the weapon zone. I'm bleeding off the energy as fast as possible, and then I'm going to configure the airplane to land. So we'll put the gear down, the flaps down, we'll get all set. We'll turn in here. We're going to come right up over this way to land on the runway down there. What we'll do is we'll stay up nice and high, and we'll get really, really slow. And right before we hit that magic number again, where we fall out of the sky, I'm going to push the nose over aggressively. So you'll feel some of those zero Gs again. We're going to point the nose straight at the ground where I want to land. Where I want the wheels to touch down is where I'm going to point the nose of the airplane. And I'm going to hold it there until I can't stand it anymore. When these guys start squirming, I know it's time to pull back. So I'll pull back, get the wheels underneath us. We'll touch down before we crash. And then I'll go max reverse and max brakes. So once we hit the ground, it's going to be an aggressive touchdown. That's the term that our PAO makes me use instead of some other words. But it's going to be aggressive. You're going to feel it hit the ground. I'm going to go max reverse, max brakes. So just like in your car when you slam on the brakes, we have an anti-lock brake system on this plane. So you'll feel the brakes catch and then release and catch and release, catch and release as we start slowing down. You'll see some smoke, smell some burning. That's all very normal. That's how these brakes are designed to operate. We're going to leave some of these tires out here on the runway as we skid to a stop. We'll stop in a very, very minimum distance. Again, that showcases for a couple things. Not only are we accelerating through the weapon zone again, but we're also landing at a minimum distance. So we have Marines down on the ground preparing a landing zone for us. They have to knock down trees. They have to grade surfaces, all that kind of stuff. We don't want them doing that for 12,000 feet. We only want them doing it for 3,000 feet. And that's all I need to get in there and drop this stuff off. So once we do hit the ground as well, you're going to see this back hatch crack open. This is our rampant door. This is the biggest hole we can make in the airplane. So this is the best way to get stuff off. So when we stop, we'll crack this thing open. We'll back up to simulate what we would do in an actual environment where we would stop, we would back up, and then we would take off again. So we'll back off, lower that ramp, and then in a combat environment, all these hard-charging devil dogs we got here in the back are going to come charging off here and go execute our fort policy, another PAO term she makes me use. But they're going to go out there and fight somebody. You know, that's what we do. So again, it's something for you guys to kind of just simulate what it looks like and what it feels like. Now, keep in mind, as we go through this, we're only going to fly for about 8.5 minutes today. When I take these guys in zone, it may take an hour, hour and a half of that kind of flying before we get to where we need to be. And then that hatch comes open, they grab all their gear they're going to need for their sustainment period, and they get off and they go fight. So just think about that. We get off the airplane, what you guys feel and what you feel like doing at that point, and think about the job that they then have to go execute. So with all of that said, does anybody have any questions for me about what we're about to do? Does everybody feel good about what we're about to go do?
Sir, yes, sir.
Yeah, all right, cool, yes, awesome. Yeah, it's going to be fun. It's going to be a really good time. By all means, if you guys do have questions or anything like that, bring them up. Kevin will answer them for you. He'll get you all set. I'm going to run upstairs and get set to go. And then once the hatch is closed and we fire up the engines, we feed off your excitement. So by all means, let us know if you guys are having a good time. And if you're not having a good time, just keep to yourself. Sound good?
Yes, sir.
All right, we'll talk to you guys then.
Sir, thank you.
I didn't realize.
Oh.
Doing well, sir.
Just pick a seat in between two buckles. Yep, there you go.
What's going on is here?
Well, okay, last time I did this, I watched 8 feet in between the elbows.
Which will make this instant famous, sir.
Oh, yeah. Selfie time.
Central.
C-130 aircraft. June 13th, 2014. Field.
we do is to simulate what.
Thank you, sir. Gentlemen.
You bet. And I guess I'll.
Oh, yeah.